Namaste, this is Kalpana, Dishwa, field specialist working in rural water supply sanitation project in Western Nepal. Today I'm going to present the role of local government in finding those who are left behind. And this case is from the Harinas rural municipality of Sangja district, Nepal. Rural water supply sanitation project is bilateral project between Nepal-Finland cooperation. As you can see in the map, we are walking here in the mid-western and western Nepal, and like similar project is working in the far western Nepal. All the activities is implemented by the local government, where the local government hired the municipality bus unit staff to do all the activities, and all the funding directly go through the local government accounts. And due to the restructuring of the Nepal, new local border has been established, where the elected local leaders are more focused on who is still behind or who is still left behind, not the scheme but the population or the household. As the entry point, we and local government took the SDG definition for the both water supply and sanitation, where all the indicators and service questionnaire are in line with the SDG definition for safely managed, which also represents the functional and the service level of the both drinking water as well as the sanitation services. And another next point is populations, which we explain in the next slide. Harinas municipality has the 7 ward. From each 7 ward, the data is collected. For the data collections, the municipality or the local government use the local data collector, which is hired by the municipality. All the data is collected is primary data, fresh data. All the data collector reach each and every household, institution, schools, and help post, asking the question related to drinking water and the sanitation, not leaving anything behind. Like this, as you can see in the picture, in the slide, there is a one which are the household which is very remote, that also cover going to the entire household geographically. For data collection, the municipality used the Kobo Collect, which is a free mobile app, and the Kobo account is handled by the municipality IT officer, and all the map are prepared by the municipality IT officer. So this is the cyclic process of municipality bus plan. As you can see, step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, step 5, there is various steps the municipality can do as needed. They can redo this cyclic process as per their requirement. In this slide, we can see the entire Harinas municipality from ward 1 to ward 7, where the local government can see the instant overview condition of the municipality in terms of the water service level, safely managed, basic, unimproved surface water, limited, where the local government instantly can prioritize from which household to be or which area to be focused first and then subsequently. So this is example of ward 1 of the Harinas about the safely managed water supplies. Here we can see the safely managed basic on improved surface water limited, how according to the SDG. And here the main point is the local government see the who are on top and who is on left behind. As you can see here, this is unimproved. They are drinking the water from unprotected spring, which is categorized as the unimproved in the SDG. So now the focus is that local government will be focusing on this area, how to manage the safely drinking water and how to prioritize prioritizing the scheme, not only the prioritizing on the basis of the scheme, but also not counting on the scheme, counting the which household is still on sub and left behind. As well, this is the sanitation ones, where you can see here, which is still not, which are on unimproved or which are open defecation. They will plan, they will activate, the local government will plan, do all the activities, focusing on those, which area to be more focused, which area to be, okay, it is going on. So this is the safely managed and this status of ward number 1. This is the example. And this is the sum figure of the sanitation, safely managed sanitation. As you can see in ward number, the open defecation is 8, unimproved 46, and limited is 32. and basic is as you can see. So which area to be more focused according to the ward wise, the ward task force will be more focused on those area. And the same as like the safely managed water, you can see here the surface water unimproved and limited, which to be more focused and which to be prioritized first on the basis of the water supply, focusing on the SDG goal. So here are the some decision made by the ward one, how to on the basis of the water supply, that some need rehabilitation and some need new schemes and some need repair only, major repair and minor repair. These are the list which the RM ward number one task force has prioritized the scheme list according to the conditions, according to this condition. So in the basic also some might need the minor repair, where in basic we included the rainwater harvesting, which not might be providing water for the a year or a 12 months. So they also included here. So this is the ward presentation, ward listing format. Thank you for listening for us and having us here. And if you want to contact, we have the Facebook page, and here it is the our contact. So thank you very much to all and listening. Namaste from Nepal.